Birthday by Meredith Russell. 13th birthday. Morgan. I'm holding my breath, hovering between wavering sunlight and deep, dark blue, arms twirling while my feet kick up and down, slow as tides. I'm not ready to go back up. Too much waits for me above the surface, but I know I just can't float forever. Life always forces you to move, one way or the other, whether you're bursting into sunlight or swimming down. The pressure in my chest is soon too much to bear. I hold my arms close and wiggle my whole body, shooting out the water like a mermaid. A minute and a half, Eric hollers, splashing me in his excitement. I can barely make out his grin as I wipe water from my eyes. Told you, I say. I can see him clearly now. He's small, a few inches shorter than me, with smart, quick green eyes, shoulder-length blonde hair, and a narrow, angle face that swoops down to a point at his chin. You still want to take a turn, or do you just give up? Never, Eric says. He gulps in as much air as he can, holds his nose, and disappears under the water. I focus on counting out the seconds, lightheaded even though I finally caught my breath. My heart is hammering. I'm gonna tell him when he comes back up. 10 seconds. I'm gonna tell him I'm supposed to be a girl, that I can't stand being a boy anymore, that I feel like I'm dying a little bit more every day. 20 seconds. A girl, a few years older than me in a red bikini, strides by the pool, heading for some distant part of the water park. I catch myself staring at a body, at the shape of it, at how it moves. I realize I've pressed my forearms over my chest and forced them back down. There's nothing to cover. 30 seconds. Eric's parents and my dad wave from their table near the pool, and I wave back. I'm gonna tell Eric, and if he takes it well, I will tell Dad. It's not that I want to. I have nightmares about making things weird with Eric or adding more stress to Dad's life after everything that's happened. But more and more, it feels like I'm gonna explode. I've tried holding it in. Every day I feel a little more numb, a little more monstrous, more afraid. I look in the mirror and find myself twisting into a tall, hairy man who never gets to turn back. I've been thinking things that scare me about not wanting to be alive anymore, and I need help. Maybe that help is my best friend, sitting calmly and letting me talk and telling me the way I feel is actually normal, that he's going through it too, that it's part of growing up and we'll pass through it together. Maybe that's my dad finding someone I can talk to, a therapist or something. I don't know. But whatever it is has to happen soon. I'm 13, and the bone-twisting terrors of puberty feel close. 40 seconds. How do you tell someone a secret like this? How do you put it into words? 50 seconds, and Eric splashes back into view, arms flailing. How'd I do? He raps. Terrible, I say. He splashes in my general direction. He's practically blind without glasses, and I laugh. How long was I under? Not even a full minute, I say, splashing him back. Whatever, he says, rolling his eyes. We don't all have your natural talent. I run every morning, I say in a sing-song voice. I'd hope exercising would soon would stop being a part of my life once I quit youth league football. But when your dad's a coach and a PE teacher, it turns out you're stuck. Work as hard as me, and you'll be as good as me, scrub. I float on my back, closing my eyes, as the sun warms my face and stomach. I take a deep breath. It's easier to imagine saying something when I can't see him. Hey, Eric. Yeah?